Today, I'm going to talk about how to choose the right kind of digestive enzymes for you, so stay tuned. Hi there, if you're new here, my name's Amanda Malacheski. I'm a certified functional nutrition health coach and a digestive and allergy detective. I help you figure out what's going on with your food allergies and digestive troubles and help you figure out what's causing them so you can stop the problem. If you'd like to hear more about this, I encourage you to subscribe to my channel and be sure to hit the bell to be notified when I post a new video every week. So there are several different kinds of digestive enzymes, and I wanted to take a minute today to just talk quickly about what those types are. And by the end of today's video, you'll have a sense of what digestive enzymes might be right for you. And this can be important because different types of enzymes serve a little bit of a different function in your body. So let's make sure that you're choosing the right kind for what's going on for you. Digestive enzymes can be a game changer for your digestion just by encouraging better breakdown of your food so that it's more easily absorbed in your intestines and is less of a burden on your organs. If you have any kind of digestive trouble, it's a great idea to include some form of digestive enzyme support. Normally, your pancreas, liver, and gallbladder produce enzymes and substances to help break down your food, but sometimes we need a little extra boost, and so this is why we use enzymes. So the first type I want to talk about are just general digestive enzyme formulas that have the three basic enzymes that our body makes, and these are protease, amylase, and lipase. Protease is the enzyme that our body makes to help break down proteins. Lipase is the enzyme that our body makes to break down fats, and amylase is the enzyme that we make to break down carbohydrates. A lot of digestive enzyme formulas just have these three components to them, and these are totally great general purpose enzymes. And these might be a good place to start because they just give you a basic supplement to what your body's already making. The second type of enzymes are proteolytic enzymes, and these basically help break down proteins. And your body also produces a lot of different varieties of these in your stomach and other places. And they are used in cellular reactions and other things like this. But they can also really help with protein digestion. And two really common sources of proteolytic enzymes are pineapple and papaya. And you see these in enzyme formulas listed as papain or bromelain. And so these are kind of good to add into your diet often because they supplement the other type of enzymes, and they're also thought to have anti-inflammatory properties. The trouble with them is that some people react to them. So if you've ever taken enzymes and gotten a funny feeling in your mouth, or if you're somebody who, when they eat pineapple or papaya, gets an itchy mouth or a swollen tongue, these types of enzymes may or may not be right for you. So be sure to test them carefully and see how you do on them. The third type of digestive enzymes are designed to address a specific kind of health condition. So these include things like gluten ease, which has an enzyme called DPPIV, which is specifically designed to help break down gluten molecules. So if you're somebody who's gluten sensitive, but maybe not celiac, and you want to try and see if you can increase your tolerance for gluten products, you could give this kind of enzyme a try. Other examples which are common are things like BINO, which is an enzyme that breaks down the particular starches that are known to cause gas from beans and legumes. Another example would be lactase, which is the enzyme that helps you break down lactose if you are lactose intolerant. And yet another example is ox bile. Now, ox bile is a bile supplement that comes from cows, and bile is the substance that our body normally produces to help break down fats. And if you are someone who has had your gallbladder removed or has gallbladder trouble or your gallbladder isn't flowing very well, you may have a shortage of bile and have difficult fat digestion. So something like ox bile could be useful in this situation. There are several other types of digestive enzymes, and some of these may be useful and beneficial for you. So the main thing that you want to focus on is just trying some enzymes and seeing how you do on them. And don't be afraid to change it up if you notice that you're having a reaction to one or the other. As I always say, it's a great idea to use some kind of tracking tool when you add something new into your diet, either whether that's a supplement or a food or a behavior, to see if you can assess how it's affecting your digestion. So I'll leave a link for my Food-Symptom Diary down below this video. That's the tool that I recommend, but you can use any other kind of tracking tool that you like to use. It's a good idea to know that you can have negative reactions to enzymes, even though most people do really well on them. The main thing that you might notice would be something like irritation in your gut. This is something that I've experienced before. It's kind of uncomfortable. So, you know, keep your eye out for that. And the other would be this discomfort in your mouth from the proteolytic enzymes. Other possibilities might be things like digestive upset, you know, diarrhea, gas, bloating, or anything like that. Certainly, if you have any kind of reaction from any supplement ever or food, that's probably something that your body doesn't need right now. So I want to hear from you. Have you experienced any relief from using digestive enzymes? Tell me about it in the comments below. If you're feeling stuck with your current digestive situation, I really want to encourage you to download a free copy of my guide called Roadmap to Gut Recovery. It's a self-help guide that gets you started on thinking about the big picture that you need to use to restore your gut health. So if you haven't already grabbed a copy of that, you can head to confluencenutrition.com/roadmap. And you can download your free copy of that guide there. I'll be sure and leave a link for that below this video. Or if you've already done that and you're still stuck, or you would like to make a time to meet with me, I am taking new clients right now, and I would love to meet with you to figure out what might be the next best steps for you. You can schedule a free session with me just to talk things over at confluencenutrition.com/contact. And I look forward to meeting you there. So that's my short little bit on digestive enzymes. I hope it's been helpful for you, and I hope that you get out there and give them a try and start trying to get your digestion working better. I will see you next time.